Hello everyone and welcome back to the Pokémon White Duo-type Nuzlocke. In the last episode we did some of the desert, and this episode we're still in the desert. Sorry. I wish I wasn't. But this is a part of the game. You technically don't have to do this, but there's a ton of trainers here that if you don't fight, you're gonna be way behind in experience and levels and stuff. Or at least in my experience you are. Alright, and this is the Relic Castle, and there's nothing in this part of it. And yeah, I'm pretty confident I can't catch anything in either the Desert Resort or the Relic Castle. I guess I could look it up just to make sure, but eh. I'm pretty confident. So yeah, also in the last episode, I asked a lot of questions, and unfortunately, by the time you're seeing this one, I will not have seen those answers yet. Because I also mentioned in the last episode that I record 3 episodes a weekend. And yeah, this is the second of my 3 episodes I'm planning to record today, May 25th. And I know May 25th is technically not a weekend, but it was an extended weekend because I had today off. Memorial Day. It's apparently a holiday in America. So yeah! Why did I even say that? I forgot where I was going with that. Why did I say that? Oh yeah, so I don't know the answers to the- I don't know what you guys said in response to my questions yet. But I do know one thing. This episode you're watching right now is being uploaded on May 29th. The day before Zhukhanov starts. Oh boy. That's a lot of pressure, don't you think? You know, for this episode, I guess. By the time I record the next episode, which is, you know, I'm going to record it right after this one. You'll see that the following Monday. You guys can kind of see my pattern of recording and uploading now, don't you? The reason I do it like that is because... So, I'm going to record the one that I'm posting next Monday. The same day. I always record 3 episodes a weekend, and I always stay 1 episode ahead of... the 3 that I'm going to be doing the week, because I need to have a clip at the end of the episode on Friday, which is this one, showing the, you know, what's next, showing a clip of the episode being posted Monday, so it has to have already been recorded for me to have a clip of it. I hope that makes sense. I hope that makes sense. Alright, Ducklet! Both of his types are good against both of my types. Isn't it hilarious? A ducklet is gonna cause problems. A ducklet. Okay. Take care of it, Jasper. Aqua Ring. That's gonna be just basically cancel out the sandstorm. See, in this episode, since I asked a bunch of questions that I'm not even gonna get to see the answers to until I upload it, which will be, I'm uploading that one on the Wednesday, the 27th. This one's uploading the 29th. So I won't even see your answers until I record next weekend. The first episode I record that weekend will be the one being uploaded on Wednesday. What day is that? Wednesday, June 3rd. So I won't even see your answers until the time you guys... I've confused myself now. That's the episode I will be recording when I will have seen your answers. So that's the first episode that you guys will see that could possibly have my responses to your answers. Did that make any sense at all? Did that make any sense at all? No. No, it didn't. Pretty sure it didn't. Wow, this ducklet is strong! What the heck? It's a ducklet! A little baby duck! Whatever, we won. You just did a lot of HP. Like, I got no experience for it. Because, you know, it's a ducklet. And here's a burn heal. You better have burn heal! It's actually a Rossberry, a natural burn heal. And Pokemans. Okay. You!
You will die.
I'll show the harshness of a desert. You know, I already know the harshness of a desert. I've wasted already an episode and, like, a quarter of another episode just being in here. Actually, more than that, because I visited the desert to catch ochre in an unrelated episode to the desert. This is a really long and boring area. And wow, that's not even doing very much HP. I guess arm thrust isn't really that great of a move. Unless it hits four or five times. Then it's a pretty decent move. And like decent, I mean, you know, it did a little over half. I feel like a strong fighting move that doesn't rely on hitting multiple times would have already hit over half. Without having to worry about that stuff. Blitzel? Thunder Wave. Ooh, that's not good. I'm paralyzed. That's okay. We'll just go to the doctor. The doctor! And Speed Rose. Sandstorm, Sandstorm. Okay. Okay. Shockwave. Yeah, guys, I have to admit, as much as I'm happy that I haven't had a death yet, it is making me feel like this game is super easy. But, like, I don't know. I don't know. It's really hard coming up with challenges, okay? It's really hard coming up with a rule that is both that has a challenge factor, is fun, and doesn't make it impossible. Or stupidly unfair. Because I gotta think of a whole bunch of rules that I could add. But the thing is, a lot of them are crappy rules. That they sound fun or hard, but they're not actually fun, and they're more in the lines of unfair or stupid. I don't know, this challenge that I'm doing right now was incredibly fun in live streams. I don't know, maybe it had something to do with the fact that I really enjoy doing live streams, and I had deaths all the time. But that's because in live streams, I'm a little less careful because, you know, it's on the dot, I'm talking to people at the same time. That's not an excuse, I'm just saying that's a reason. And then, yeah, I also don't do hardly any training in live stream playthroughs, because who the heck wants to see that live? I barely even want to show it in video form. So who would want to watch me actually do it live? And Rock Tomb, that might come in handy for Alisa, the next gym leader. She's one of the harder ones, in my opinion. Or she can be, if you don't know what you're doing. See? Never mind. So anyway! I don't even know what I was going to say now. Let's have Jasper up front. Maybe it'll lower the encounter rate a little bit. Doubt it, though. I think we're ready to go in the ruins. There aren't too many trainers in there.
But there is one. One specific trainer.
There is one specific trainer in here.
This guy. He is in possession of the true...
How can I describe this?
The truly most evil thing in the entire universe region! The most evil... horrible, disgusting thing you can imagine. It is... Sigilyph! My ultimate enemy!
Why is Sigilyph the ultimate enemy? Because... well, not only is he really overpowered early in the game, so it's very easy for him to kill someone. I'm pretty sure he was the cause of two deaths in my original Black Nuzlocke. I know for a fact he killed Elvis, the Rock'n'Rolla. And he was my favorite member at the time. This specific one I'm fighting right now killed it. And I'm pretty sure another one killed another one in Pokemon I really can't remember, to be honest. But it doesn't look like it's posing much of a threat this time around. Although it's not over yet, it easily could turn things around. Ha! Nice job, Jasper! Nice job! You've destroyed the ultimate evil. But it's only a matter of time before it's re-released and wreaks havoc upon the world again. It's like an RPG storyline. Yeah. Yeah, that was that. Ochre, your turn. There's another psychic over here. And then I think it's the last trainer we have to deal with. Then we can leave. It fills you with magical power. Yay, magic! Pretty sure it's called psychic, not magic. But that's okay. We can call it magic if you want. Her name is Dua. Dua? Dua type Nuzlocke? Oh boy. Feet attack! Should've used payback, but oh well. I didn't know. I should've known though, because Wooass really fast. Didn't matter, killed it in one hit anyway. MOXEH! Muna! Now I bet I'm faster than Muna. Let's go over. Yes, I was right, okay. Still killed in one hit because of MOXEH! MOXEH! Yeah, Dua. I'm full of magical power. Yes, magic. Alright, this lady. Oh, this is a trainer too, isn't she? I thought she was the fossil person. Maybe she is the fossil person. Are you the fossil person? I think you're the fossil person. Yes, you're the fossil person! Yes, I'm gonna take. I literally don't remember which fossil is which, but I'm gonna kick the plume one, I guess. Bird Pokemon! Okay, there you go. That's Archaeops, okay. Doesn't matter, I can't use either of them anyway, so it really doesn't matter which one I pick. And you're gonna tell me I can't move forward because of plot convenience. Is there anything down in the pits? I think there is something, like an item or two. An elixir! I had a feeling there was a hidden item there. Is there one on this sand pile? No. And a revive. So helpful. And Pokemans. You know what? I think I'm just going to meet you guys back at the next part I have to be at. Because I think we're done with the Relic Castle in the desert. I'll meet you back on the route, the little pathway going north of the desert. Alright, here we are. You're not a trainer, are you? Nope. You're not. And you are, I bet. Who do I have up front right now? Ochre. That's fine, I guess. What difference does it make? Until I know what you have, it really doesn't matter. Traveling backpacker meets a traveling trainer. Do you narrate your life? What a weirdo! Narrating everything they do. Ha! Wait a minute. So anyway, he has a pit of. Yeah, ochre's not a good idea, I guess. But you know what? You know what I say? Screw it! Go for it! It's level freaking 19! It's not like it resists fighting. Yeah! What the heck? MOXEH! What the heck? Guys, I'm not gonna try to lose, okay? There's no way I'm gonna make this easier for me. I really thought I'd have a few deaths by now. Like, holy crap. This is, I really hate to say this, but this is easy! Why is this easy? This is harder than my last challenge! Oh boy. Maybe I'm not good at thinking of new challenges. I guess the thing is, if a death ever happens, it is a very significant occurrence, though. But they haven't, it hasn't even happened yet. And I'm pretty sure I'm about to get over 6 Pokemon. I'm pretty sure I can catch some more Pokemon in the next few routes. There's a lot of routes surrounding Nimbasa. I'm pretty sure there's at least a few I can catch on each overall. So here's some Plasma people. I'm going to get a bicycle out of this. I'm happy about that. And that's the daycare man! Once you save him, he'll open up his daycare way back on the route we've already passed a long time ago. So, yeah. Not that we can use that anyway, because the daycare is off. It's against the rules. Team Plasma Grunt with a Watchog. Oh no! Machag! Level 18. That's weaker than Lenora's. Which was the gym, which was not even the last gym we fought. Black and White, I'm just realizing now, has some really weird levels. Like, I don't know. Is it just me? Maybe it's just the way I'm playing. MOXEH! Maybe it's just the way I'm playing. I don't know. Yay, level 25 for Okra! I know it's Okra, I just felt like pronouncing it wrong. Main attack! The pile of garbage! The epic pile of garbage, which is an awesome Pokemon. Not a crappy Pokemon. MOXEH! Now, I actually don't think Trubbish is an awesome Pokemon. I don't really like it that much at all, but it's not a crappy design. It's no different than any other Pokemon made ever. Thank you so much! You're talking my gratitude as a bike! He pulls his bike out of his pants. Here, have my bike. That was just in your pants, man. Hey, I don't tell you how to live your life. Take the bike, ride it, or don't ride it. I don't care. Goodbye. Yoo-hoo! Oh, great, it's Bianca. Hello, Bianca. And things. I'm gonna go see the Pokemon musical. Good for you. Isn't there supposed to be a thing here? Yes, you. You give me something, right? Yes. Okay, I don't think it's not gonna be necessary for this playthrough in the slightest. Or ever, actually, because you can't do Wi-Fi battles on DS games anymore. So yay! So the only thing I record is the Battle Subway battles, and who the heck wants to see that? Alright, yay, healing point! JK, we just get to heal because I like healing. And there's no healing point rule. You know, maybe that is making a difference. Somehow I doubt it, though. I really doubt that's making a difference. Like, I would just be using, instead of healing every time I see a healing place, I would just be using items after every single battle. It's not like battles would be different. It's just that I would have less money. That's it. That's the only difference that, between if I had healing points and now. There's a person here that gives me a sunstone, I believe, and I don't think... Oh, wait, no! Not this house. That's the thing that I don't like. But, you know, I don't even need a sunstone. No one I could possibly have evolved my sunstone, so forget it. You know what? I think we're almost done with this episode. You know what? Let's fight N first. Let's get that over with before we... It might be a longer-ish episode, but I don't really care. We're gonna start with Prune, because I feel like it. Not because I don't remember what N starts with, because I don't feel like it. There's N. Hello, N. You leave your Team Plaza, right? They're in the amusement park. Come with me. Where are we going, N? Where are we going? I don't know if I like this. They're not here. Let's ride the Ferris wheel and see if we can spot them. I love Ferris wheels. The circular motion, the mechanics. They're like the collection of elegant formulas. Ferris wheels. They go round and round and round. The world is round. Pokeballs are round. I said that wrong, but yeah. Oh my god, it's the King of Team Plasma! Oh my god! Oh my god, plot twist! Who saw that coming, right? Who saw that coming? Oh my god. Getzus. Also, Getzus isn't the leader. Ooh. Shh, spoiler, he really is, kinda. I mean, he's not really... N is quote-unquote the leader... But Getzus is the mastermind behind all of it. And is that spoilers? Probably, but I don't really care. It's an old game. My Lord N! You're safe, sire. There's no problem. Also, why is N considered a king of Team Plasma? You follow my logic? No. Just because, you know, I have to disagree with him. Because even if I said yes, he'll say, oh, well, I'm going to fight you anyway. That makes no sense! Alright, I was definitely saying something before. I forgot what it was. Oh yeah, King Team Plasma. Why King? Every other, evil team just has, like, I don't know, a leader. Aqua leader, Magma leader, Team Rocket leader. Why is that a king? And like I did say, Team Plasma, their uniforms are based off of knights. So maybe it's just supposed to go along with that theme? Or is Team Plasma secretly a kingdom? And... Come on! Why else call him a king? If he's not the leader of a kingdom. So these are basically invaders from the Plasma Kingdom. Here to take over the Unova region. By telling us that we shouldn't have Pokemon anymore. It all makes sense now. Uh-oh, this isn't good. Olive. Ooh. Well. You can kill it. No MOXEH for you! I don't even know if Mr. Craigie had MOXEH, but yeah, still. Alright, we're just switching out for Darumaka. Let's go to Crimson. Crimson! Fire Punch! That's why I switched into Crimson, so it can resist the fire attacks. And it still did quite a lot of damage. Because of its Hustle ability. Force Slap power of Slap. 3 times. We need 4 times next turn. Ooh, that did a lot of HP. Like an uncomfortable amount of HP, actually. It's getting interesting. Alright, Jasper, intimidate it. Yeah, intimidate, well, that helped. Headbutt, it missed. Because of Hustle. Nice. Retaliate! Done. You're done, son. I shouldn't talk like that. Sittilith! It's Sittilith. Crunch it. Crunch it. Why is he using Talon? It's already faster, and it's the only Pokemon left. Now it's half dead. And Psybeam, unless this is like a super mega critical hit. It was a super mega critical hit! Well, it wasn't a super mega critical hit, it was just a regular critical hit, which was not enough! Whew! I almost had a death, but I didn't! I easily could have died if I played incorrectly. But, yeah. Ooh. Creepy close-up. Try to stop me if you dare. Why do you have to challenge the Pokemon League in order to accomplish your goals? I mean, all you have to do is make friends with Reshiram, right? Why do you have to become the champion? Yeah, I've mentioned this every time I played these games, but it just seems weird to me that they're implying the champion is like the president or like the leader of the region. It's like, so if you become the champion, it's like you're overthrowing the previous like leader. And becoming the new leader. That just seems so weird to me. But that is implied in these games many times. But it's not in like any other game ever. Unless I just missed that. But whatever. That is the end of this episode. I hope you look forward to the next episode where we're going to start Elise's gym. I don't know if we're going to beat her or reach her. But that's the plan for the next episode. Thank you for watching and I hope you enjoyed. Rock on.